Johnson & Johnson and AstraZeneca vaccines focus on using a viral vector technology to give us protection from SARS-CoV-2. Now, currently, these vaccines are being monitored in Europe and in the United States, as in the United States, of over 6.8 million doses of Johnson & Johnson that have been given, there have been 6 reports of a specific type of blood clot, abbreviated CVST, that's also associated with low levels of platelets. Now, there has been no connection between the vaccine and these blood clots, as there could be other reasons that these blood clots occur, such as one's genetics, other comorbidities they have, or conditions or medicine that these individuals are taking that could also predispose them to a blood clot. However, we want to ensure that every single individual can have a safe vaccine against SARS-CoV-2. So these individuals are being investigated to see what is the connection between this specific type of blood clot and the viral vector technology. So in the US, the announcement was made that the Johnson & Johnson vaccines would be paused for 2 main reasons. The first, this allows individuals who have received a Johnson & Johnson vaccine to monitor themselves for any symptoms related to these blood clots. Additionally, it allows medical facilities to find and treat better these blood clots in case any more cases arise. Now, moving forward, what does this mean in terms of medicine and vaccines? It shows us that every individual is very unique, especially when it comes to our own genetics, and that we're moving more towards individualized medicine, and that what medicine works for someone might not work for another. And that's why we need multiple medicines that use different pathways to get to the same destination. And luckily, in the US, we can do that with other vaccines against SARS-CoV-2, such as the Pfizer or Moderna vaccines that use mRNA technology. And these vaccines have not been associated with any form of blood clot and are still safe and effective.